I don't know what your problem is. I am a reasonable man. We just live in an unreasonable world sometimes. For the last 2 weeks, my wife has been bitching and complaining that the neighbor behind us's dogs are barking at night and keeping her up. And I told her, hey, I'm not the ASPCA. If these yahoos want to turn their backyard into white trash wild kingdom, so be it. I spend most of my life traveling to far-flung, pain-in-the-ass, third-world shitholes just to defend these idiots' rights to be goddamn morons. So then I'm home last Sunday night trying to watch a movie with my kids, and sure as shit, the neighbor's dogs start barking. And it's annoying, but it's not the end of the world. And then my wife comes in the living room all worked up saying how her prized Himalayan cat, Mr. Whiskers, is missing. I tell her to calm down and that it's not a big deal. She says that it is a big deal because her and Mr. Whiskers watch Sex and the City DVDs on her computer every Saturday night in bed and that he never misses an episode. By the way, I'm pretty sure Mr. Whiskers is gay. I'm just saying. I tell my old lady that he probably snuck outside earlier when I was bringing in the groceries and that he'll be back in the morning. No big deal. And then she starts crying and carrying on about how Mr. Whiskers is an indoor cat and he can't survive in the wild. Jesus Christ. I tell her that if she quits belly aching, I'll take a look outside and see if I can find him. So I go out in the backyard, and I hear a bunch of growling and snarling coming over the back wall. I take a peek on the other side, and sure as shit, I see Mr. Whiskers in the neighbor's backyard. And then I see like 10 or 12 of the biggest goddamn pit bulls I've ever seen surrounding him, about to go in for the kill. Turns out my dick-shitting hillbilly neighbors are running some type of illegal fighting dog puppy mill right next to us, and Mr. Whiskers has just wandered into the center of a canine shitstorm. I hop the back wall, scoop up the furry little homo, and then all the dogs really start going ape shit. Just then our neighbor comes out his back door and starts hollering about how I'm trespassing and how I'm about to be in a world of pain. Why do douchebags always say that? I laugh because even though I'm holding the world's gayest cat, I know I'm about 2 seconds away from whipping out my Gerber tactical knife and turning this guy's prized leg humpers into a set of new seat covers and car bra for my minivan. I tell the guy to just call his dogs off and we'll call it even for the night, and he tells me to go fuck myself. I tell him, if he keeps pushing it, not only am I going to butt-fuck his soul, I'm going to do it while giving him a reach around with a pair of rusty pliers. And again, he tells me to go fuck myself. So I say, alright you human colostomy bag, get ready to meet Stanley. Stanley is my pet African honey badger that I rescued from a Janjaweed training camp outside of Darfur back in 04. The Janjaweed, the inhuman cock guzzlers that they are, trapped Stanley as a baby and kept him around the camp chained to a log so they could kick him and put cigarettes out on him for fun. They also forced him to fight dangerous animals from the region for their pleasure and to place bets on. And Stanley never lost a fight. On the night of the raid, when I freed him from his chains, he took off through the camp and bit the dick off of every one of those heartless sons of bitches. And their horses, and their children, and their horses' children. And he never looked back. He's been with me ever since. Spends most of the day sleeping under our house. He refuses to eat anything except coffee grounds and beef jerky, Slim Jims in particular. And he chain smokes like a fiend, Camels, unfiltered. He gets along great with my kids and my family, and he doesn't look for trouble. But when trouble comes looking for him, that's a whole nother story. And there Stanley was, perched atop that 8-foot block wall, just 42 pounds of pure, unadulterated hatred and nicotine, ready to unleash his fury. And before you can say, I'm gonna gouge out your eyes and then shit in your eye sockets, Stanley leaps off the wall, grabs the first mutt that comes at him, pins it to the concrete, gouges out its eyes, and then shits directly into its eye sockets. And then it got ugly. The next 15 minutes were a veritable blood orgy. Stanley took on wave after wave of surly pit bull, 2, 3, 4 at a time, slashing with his claws and gnashing with his razor-sharp teeth, dispatching one after another straight to doggy hell, his golden fur caked in their blood, brains, and entrails. Near the end of the battle, as a last-ditch effort, my neighbor punches the numbers into the security keypad of this oversized tool shed with the name Lucifer painted on the side and releases the biggest goddamn dog I've ever seen in my life. This thing stood over 5 feet tall, weighed over 250 pounds, and had a giant 2-foot swastika shaved onto each side of its back. Lucifer leapt out of the shed and made straight for Stanley. Without skipping a beat, Stanley snapped the neck and ripped the head off of the nearest pit bull at its feet, and then worked up his little badger boner and stuck the severed head onto the end of it. As Lucifer pounced, aiming his bear trap-sized jaws at Stanley's jugular, Stanley performed a spin kick, knocking the dog's legs out from under him. Then Stanley pounced on Lucifer's back and penetrated him from behind, wearing one of the monster's own cohort's severed heads, tongue still wiggling in its mouth, and fucked him in the ass. Lucifer let out a yelp that could have raised Lazarus himself from the dead. The dickhead neighbor falls to the ground, weeping into his hands, gold chains, and Undertaker tank top. And Stanley just stands there, thrusting and thrusting and thrusting, literally raping Lucifer to death. Right before Stanley climaxed, he pulled back, yanked the severed head off of his cock, and bukkakied my neighbor's face, covering him in a deluge of honey badger semen and pit bull blood and tears. It was the most amazing goddamn thing I've ever seen in my life. And from what I hear, after all is said and done, the neighbor douchebag had a nervous breakdown and is still being treated in a Navy mental hospital just outside of 29 Palms. It just goes to show, don't mess with a man's faggoty cat or be prepared to reap the whirlwind of pain and despair that comes along with it. Rangers lead the way, Honey Badger FTW.